Hi guys, welcome back to Dolphin's Kitchen. I hope everyone is doing well. As we all know, all this COVID and this lockdown, I hope you haven't really been affected too much, and my heart goes out to those who have been affected. Anyway guys, enough about that. Today's video, we're going to be preparing chicken meatloaf with a twist and with a bit of bacon and broccoli. All right guys, let's go to the ingredients. So guys, we have here my chicken breast. This is about 2 kg, because I'm making a big one. I mean, you can half it if you want to do a small one. So that is it, enough. I've whacked it. My hands are clean, guys. I've whacked it with my my rolling pin to flatten it, to make it a bit thin. I left this one to show you how I did it. And also I have here my broccoli, which I've chopped it really fine. I have here some dry curd streaky bacon rushes. This one's, I've got 2 packets here. I'm not too sure if I'm gonna use the lot, but I've got 2 packets because I'm doing a big meatloaf. And I've got here my cheddar cheese. And I have also here my chopped garlic. That's about 8 cloves. And I've got here a tablespoon of salt, tablespoon of black pepper, and I've got 2.5 tablespoons of mayonnaise, and I have here some butter. This is about, I would say, 2 tablespoons. Right, first of all guys, we're going to, before I show you how I did my chicken breast, I need to do this, cook this broccoli a little bit in a frying pan with our butter. Then we come back to, whilst it's cooking, we can do the chicken. Right guys, so we first have to add in our butter. And our garlic. I'm going to add in our broccoli. Stir it in nicely and gentle. Oh, the garlic. Oh, the smell is so amazing, guys. Whilst I'm stirring this in, we can put in our black pepper and our salt. We're going to be frying this for about 5 minutes. You don't want it really overcooked. Right guys, I'm gonna put the fire off now. And we'll take it off the fire. So guys, this is how I whacked my breast to thin it a little bit. I put in a bag, in the freezer bag. And basically just use my my roller pin. That's it guys, it's all flattened up and It's gone a bit thinner. See? That's it. So it's easy, and it doesn't take too long to cook. So right, guys, now we're going to roll our chicken. And so we first need to lay them out. And on the parchment paper, yeah? So guys, we've laid our chicken breast all down flat nicely. So let's put it on the side for a minute. So we take our broccoli. We're going to mix in our cheddar cheese. And our mayo. You can add in mustard if you like. So we just mix it in nicely. Right, guys, so that's our chicken breast laid out, and our mix is also here. And before I put in the filling, the mix, I've decided to add just a little bit of my all-purpose seasoning, because I want some nice taste in the chicken. So roughly, I would say about a tablespoon of all-purpose. And this has ginger, it's got garlic, it's got onion powder. Nice aroma. Right, that should do. And now we're going to put in our mix. Right, then we're gonna spread them now. So after we finish spreading it, guys, we have to roll this into a log. And that's where sometimes, fingers crossed, sometimes I struggle a little bit. Right, so here we go, guys. Especially when you're doing a big one, it's a bit hard to roll. Right, guys, finally, as I said, because it's a large one, so it's a bit of a struggle. So I finally rolled it. So we're going to chill this for about 45 minutes. After the 45 minutes, we come back and wrap the bacon around it before we bake it. Right, guys, so in 45 minutes, we'll come back. So guys, we've got our chicken out of the freezer, out of the chill, and it's looking okay, but this thing has turned up too big. So right, and we've got our bacon crisscrossed here, and we're gonna try and roll it again. Fingers crossed, it's not gonna be too messy. And the bacon that I thought I wasn't gonna use, the 2 packet, guys, it turned out it wasn't even enough. But hey, that was all I had, so unfortunately that would be it. It would have to do so. Now roll it, and we have to put it in our tray. Right, so guys, our meatloaf or our chicken loaf, it's in our baking dish. So this is going to go in the oven for about 40 minutes or 30 to 40 minutes. After 30 minutes, we're gonna bring it out and see how it's looking, and maybe brush it down with a little bit of honey and pop it in there for a few minutes again. So this is going in now, guys, and the oven is preheated at 350. So it's gonna take its time and really cook through. Right, guys, so this has been in there for about 40 minutes now. So we're going to just brush a little bit of honey on the top for that shiny glaze. We have a few punches there, but never mind, it's still going to be delicious anyway. Right, guys, so this is going to go in again for about 20 minutes and we'll be done, guys. We will be done. So I'm gonna pop this back in for 20 minutes. Okay, guys. Guys, our chicken loaf, it's done. Voila, look at it, it's looking so delicious and the fragrance is amazing, guys. Right, guys, so here we are. I'm having mine with chips today, and guys, please do give it a try, guys, and let me know what you think. If you like it, please do give me a thumbs up. And thank you very much, guys, for sticking with me, watching me cook my meatloaf or chicken loaf. Yeah, guys. And please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my videos. And I shall see you in my next video.